Hey guys, how's it going and welcome back for another Total War video with the Terminator. Of all the cultures in Europe during the medieval ages, from the savage Brits to the grand caliphates of North Africa, there is one group of people that has always fascinated me. And I never felt like Total War games really captured the right feel or engagement for these ruthless raiders of the North. I am of course talking about the Vikings. Thrones of Britannia was centered around the Viking invasions of the British Isles, and while there were some interesting aspects to the game, the visuals were fantastic of course, and the battles were so much fun, other issues bogged it down. We've got various Viking-like factions in Attila or its DLCs, but that's all they were really, bland, vanilla, playable factions. We've never really had a proper Viking Total War. Well, with that in mind, today's video is not about one, but two Viking era mods that you absolutely need to try. Age of Vikings for Attila Total War and Viking Age for Rome 2 Total War may be tackling the same era on two different games, but they offer very unique styles, factions, units, and gameplay mechanics that make them very unique and definitely worth trying out. So let's get started. Made for the beloved Age of Charlemagne DLC for Attila Total War, Age of Vikings is a total overhaul mod that tries to be as historical as possible, but also has some slight influences from the Vikings and the Last Kingdom TV shows. The mod comes with loads of new factions and faction-specific historically accurate characters and family trees. There are over 100 new and unique units across the board that again are more historically accurate and look absolutely fantastic. The modding team have also done a lot of work on adding new traits and edicts, as well as making all playable factions as immersive and engaging as possible with some brilliant missions and events. The mod has a starting year of 868 AD and comes with 10 playable factions. However, there is a submod called the Faction Pack DLC that you can also download from the Steam Workshop, which adds 3 more playable factions, bringing the total to 13. From the Danes or Danelaw to the kingdoms of Wessex, Italy, or the Emirates of Sicily or Cordoba, there is a real variety in the playable factions that makes this mod highly replayable. One of the best things about Age of Vikings, though, is it might be the most balanced campaign I've ever played, and that's saying a lot, guys. The Danish kingdoms have proper starting positions for one, which is a huge plus for me, as most mods or even vanilla campaigns don't quite get this right. Each faction starts with some very unique circumstances, and because it's on the Age of Charlemagne map, you have lots of cities, lots of potential enemies and allies, and fabulous avenues for expansion that normally would be quite limiting in other mods or games. The best kind of Total War campaign, anyone will tell you, compels you to just say one more turn. And without a doubt, Age of Vikings does this in almost every single way possible. So much effort has gone into making playable factions the best that they can be, polishing off gameplay mechanics, balancing unit rosters, and more. And all of that adds to a fantastic campaign experience that I cannot recommend enough. And then there are the units, guys, which look absolutely insane. In my personal experience, Attila battles are too fast-paced, but Age of Vikings does a decent job of slowing things down, and coupled with the brilliant-looking units, you can't help but pause during a crucial moment in the battle to step away from the micromanaging and get a closer look at the action. Overall, Age of Vikings does a really good job of giving the player a well-balanced, diverse, and engaging Viking-era Total War experience that in some ways is more enjoyable than Thrones of Britannia or other mods for the period. If you're looking to try it, I promise you will not regret it. Viking Age is essentially the Rome 2 Total War equivalent of Age of Vikings for Attila, which means optimization and performance isn't as much of an issue, battles are a bit slower paced, and there is a different visual feel with Rome 2 being lighter and more colorful versus Attila's more dark atmosphere. The other big pro to Viking Age, of course, is that it uses the Grand Campaign map, which is far larger than the Age of Charlemagne map of Age of Vikings. What really sets Viking Age apart from Age of Vikings is the new and unique cultures and culture systems and the playable factions that are built around them. You've got Christianity, which of course is led by our Western European factions. You've got the Islamic factions all across North Africa. You've got Northern cultures, which make up our pagan Viking factions. And you've got the very unique Buddhist and Tengrist cultures, which come with Tibet. And a lot more. Roman successor kingdoms like Beneventum, the Eastern Roman Empire. All in all, the mod comes with 36 playable factions, far more than in Age of Vikings, and they are all very diverse and replayable. Viking Age also comes with over 180 new units, including 24 naval units, like the Viking expedition ships manned by fierce sword warriors or Viking archers, or the Viking mercenaries, which really do pack a punch. Constantinople has been moved to a better position on the map. There are new buildings, new weapons, new regions, and technologies that all come together to provide a very engaging Viking experience. For me, though, the most impressive part is the units and unit variety. While unit icons and cards haven't changed, the fabulous armor, weapons like maces or two-handed infantry, the fantastic-looking Viking warriors, all the units really look so well done and really make battle gameplay absolutely amazing. The mod rebalances all factions, not just from a campaign point of view, but also for battles, so that, again, pacing is a bit slower and more engaging, which all lends itself to a much more enjoyable Total War experience. The only caveat with Viking Age is that in order to play it, you need to have the Rome 2 Beta 17 downloaded on Steam. So if you download all 6 parts of the mod, make sure you right-click on Rome 2, go into Properties, then Betas, and choose Beta 17, as that is what the mod is built for. Overall, Viking Age is a brilliant take on the time period with a lot of great playable factions, nicely done and balanced building trees and unit rosters, fantastic looking detailed units, and just a really enjoyable Viking campaign. I would definitely recommend you check it out. And that's it for today, guys. I was a massive fan of the concept of Thrones of Britannia when it first came out, but the lack of unit diversity and a very weirdly designed campaign mode made me go back to games like Attila and Rome 2 pretty quickly. But with mods like Age of Vikings or Viking Age, you can still enjoy a really great Viking campaign to raid, pillage, and raise to your heart's desire. If you do decide to try out either of these mods, guys, I've linked them below in the video description. Just make sure you get all the different parts and take a look at the sub mods as well. Make sure you've got the correct load order, and that's really important, guys. And for Viking Age, make sure you've got the beta enabled for it to work correctly. Hope you enjoyed this video, guys, and if you did, give it a like and drop any thoughts or questions in the comments section below. Subscribe for more Total War content, gameplay, and news. And thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you next time.